Hello everybody, I'm Pierre Farrugia. We are with Vince Paca and Angelo Caruana. Today we are in Kalkara and we're going to explore Fort St Rocco. So let's start this adventure. First tunnel. Looks interesting already. Remember, this was a fort and mostly used in World War II. See? This fort was built in 1872 and was upgraded to what it is now in 1900. Let's continue the story. Well, one particularity of this fort is that it's a polygonal shaped fort that was built here. So let's continue to explore this area. This most probably where they stored ammunition. And if anybody knows anything different, please comment. Now we are going in this area, which is very small. What is interesting for us, look. Remember that this area here was used also by the film studio, so we might find even some props as well here. As we see here.
We found a big, what do you call it, an iron door.
Very strong.
Very, very heavy door for what
and
it is.
And looks, that is the part of this fort,
I
not
think
a prop.
Yes, look, because it's very heavy duty. We open it. And look what we find.
That was like a circle. Even the what's written here, St. Rocco, CP. Now I'm going on top of the structure that we just entered. As you can see here, the circular part is where the cannons used to be. There were used to be three here, if I'm not mistaken. And one of these cannons became famous in 17 May 1942, when one of these cannon from here, look at the view, sunk an Italian U-boat that was going to attack Grand Harbor. And this is where the base of the cannon used to be. Now we're going to continue exploring the tunnels connecting these cannon bases. Now we are visiting another part of this fort. We are doing mostly tunnels and going down the stairs. Remember that here it was used from the Malta film studios as well. So that's why sometimes you find props. You can see, hang on some here. These are props from the films. Remember that this was a base from the 1800s going back and mostly used in World War II. Let's see, look how interesting this is. Gates. This is the part we are exploring right now. And this is the upper level of the area where before. It's like a big garage. Some items that were left here from the movie park, because part of this base was used as a movie park. And here, most probably goes down to the lower areas, which we'll visit soon as well. Now we are going to visit another underground tunnel. tunnel going underground again to visit this part. As you can see here, you have to take care because there's a lot of wood, part of the Rinella studios, and we are going inside there. Going in. What do you think, Anj? You go inside?
Yes.
Seems. Let's go. We have to take care.
A lot of material here, wood.
And this is the most interesting part, so let's go. Here we already started finding some props. It's not from World War II for sure, but from the when they used to do movies here. So let's come inside. Angelo, take great care here because this wood has fallen off. There's more props here. Look how many props there are here, Ange. It's full here of props. Let me hold this wood for you. There's Angelo. An old pairing. What's this? Maybe props, kind of props. Here we can find all sorts of props. Very old lamp. This is a bit delight. And this, unfortunately, as many places, this looks that have been burned out. It's a pity, I don't know why people destroy everything they found, eh? Because this has importance to history apart from the props. From what we can see here, there are a lot of movie props. Look, names, part of like uniforms which are not real, they are film props. Where you can take a bath, old chairs, more old chairs, lamps, old lamps. We have a boat here as well. Look.
Yeah, we have a boat for summer experience, okay?
A small boat, which is a movie prop as well. We have a very old stretcher here, a mailbox, an old mailbox. See? This is the stretcher I was telling you about. And we have a lot of stuff, old beds, part of motorcycles. We have here old bicycles. What do you think, Paka? Nice, eh? Interesting.
Very nice, eh? Very interesting. Maybe these bicycles, examples are very interesting.
Remember that here is still, we are in Fort St Rocco, eh? This area. Look what I found here, Paka. Look what I found.
What's that? What's that?
Help me up.
Jesus.
We have a shark.
Shark.
Oh. We have found a shark, yeah? Look.
A dead shark.
A dead shark, yeah? Auntie, how you say it? It's cooked. Cooked. This must be part of the Titanic chimney. Interesting stuff. What we have here? Here is something else. But the pity because it was burned. Here, everything. Here are some props of helmets. But as you can see, everything was burned up. It is a pity. Let's continue exploring this area. We are still going in. As I told you before, people burn everywhere here, which is a shame when you see everything burned, because here you have to remember this history. Lots and history. Look what Angelo pointed out. We have found artificial stalactites in this area. It's not made from limestone or rock. Here is everything burned up, as I told you before, which is a pity. There used to be like fiberglass uniforms here, part of the film studios. And here we have an opening that goes. This here, if we go out from here, we'll find the base of the cannons that I showed you before. Now we are going to the other side because we came in from here. And now we are going to the second opening. As we say, hope we make awareness for people not to burn, destroy, or take anything from any place. We just watch, we only take video with us, because we leave this to other people to enjoy. This is a lot of burnt helmets, and lead us again to another base where the cannons used to be. Exploring this area, we have finished this part, and we have to move on to find other places. I remind you, this was the Rinella movie park, because the Rinella movie park is built inside this beautiful fort, which is a pity, left in the States. What do you think, guys? Let's continue exploring. When you see this circular part here with the railing, means that if you go up here, you will find the base of another cannon. You see? And here you can see goes down, and unfortunately burnt as well. What a pity. Well, we are going down in the third. I don't know if it's called, can this be called a bunker? No, I don't think so. It's an underground facility in this area. People coming here always take care, because easily one can get injured. Stairs from both sides, as you can see. This have been used something by the movie Parker. It's like it's painted up and with rocks. Yeah. Is it there? You can see those massive doors. It's another interesting place here. You see? The wall is painted like old rock. And here is the opening, which I showed you before, to lower maybe ammunitions or stuff. Now we can continue to the other side. It looks very creepy, with the light coming from outside. Another opening. Remember, this was used in like a fort, so, and then turned it into a movie park. Yeah. So it was painted and adjusted to accommodate the movie park. Tough stuff to see and explore. This is the way we came in. Look, there's something to do with the studio here. Nothing good, but it's very big piano here. And interesting to explore. I didn't think it was so big. This is the room I came in earlier. Well, this corridor here leads to another cannon bay there, but the problem here is that it's flooded. Let's try to walk on this. Not to go down. I'm trying not to get wet. Eh? I'm moving on movie blocks. And here we end up. But here, as you can see, it's water. I'm moving on these blocks and trying not to get in. So now we're going to explore the area there. Alright, look what we found here. This looks very interesting. You see, when I see these colors, it's like military. It could be a probe, because here there's the biggest problem.
You see? There's five category, five CAT, that one.
Yeah, see that?
Yellow.
It looks old as well.
It has a, what do we call it? Like a...
Loop, highly. Interesting stuff, but the most interesting is this, the coloring. The coloring it has, the most interesting is the coloring and the letters. Looks something military, but as I was saying before, since this is a movie pro, a movie area, it could be a movie pro, but it looks very real. So let's continue exploring. And we are
vandalisms for
yes, that's a pity.
But
so today we are here again at the movie park, but we are realizing how much stuff there is to visit, more than we visit last time.
Yes.
And now we're going to go underground again. This part of the prop, not part of here. So let's continue. Here, this flooded part is where I walked from the tunnel before, where I was walking on the burned wood and the water, because there's full of water. And here it's flooded as well. You can see here. There's another chamber here. And then if we go to this part here, if we walk all the way, we will find the base where the cannons used to be. Well, I'm going in this area. Look here what I found, Ange. Very interesting. Look here. This writing with the Maltese cross.
Okay.
You see? And there was an emblem or something, and there's something written here, but I cannot. Number 13, arrow. First, what is this? B-T-Y-R-M. A. And this is import number 13. Anybody knows what this is? We'll check the footage on the computer. Everywhere you see here, there are massive steel doors. We are still underground. And here, we are exploring another big room. The threads you can see here and all around, near even where there's Paca, this circular base was the base where the cannon used to be, and these where it was bolted to the ground. Let's do a top shot from here. Here, as you can see, it's very interesting, made of concrete, which is very, very strong, and it's an extra structure here. Well, we are going back out. Everywhere you can see there are these massive doors. Okay. We are going back out of this area. Hope you enjoyed this adventure here at Fort St Rocco. Mostly we've done the tunnels today and underground. Today it's Angelo Caruana, Vince Paca and Pierre Farrugia. Please subscribe to our channel and like this video, and hopefully you share it again. Until next time, bye-bye.
Bye.